Welcome to the City of Calgary Municipal Complex Virtual Tour. The City of Calgary is located on the traditional territory of the Blackfoot, which includes the Siksika, the Piikani, and the Kainai First Nations. The Stoney Nakoda, which includes Chiniki, Bearspaw, and Wesley First Nations, and the Soutina First Nation. The City of Calgary is also the traditional homeland of the historic Northwest Métis and is home to Métis Nation of Alberta, Region 3. Calgary is the third largest municipality in Canada, serving over 1.3 million people. Calgarians are young and diverse, with thousands of new people arriving annually from across Canada and around the world. We're accessible and inclusive and value diverse perspectives. The Municipal Complex. Calgary's municipal government, made up of elected council members and administration, is located in three interconnected buildings in downtown Calgary. This municipal complex is often referred to as City Hall and includes Historic City Hall, the Administration Building, the Municipal Building, and an outdoor plaza. The complex is on the City Hall C Train Station southbound platform and connected to Bow Valley College to the north and Art Commons to the west via the city's Plus 15 walkway network. This is the main entrance to the municipal complex that brings you into the atrium on the plaza level or second floor. The centerpiece of the atrium is Council Chamber. Council Chamber is where all City of Calgary Council meetings take place, as well as some board and committee meetings. Decisions that have an important place in the lives of all Calgarians happen here. The mayor sits at the front of the room with the city manager on one side and the city solicitor on the other. There are 14 councillors, one representing each ward. Seven sit on each side. The city clerk and legislative advisors make sure the meetings run smoothly and document all decisions that are made. The city has six general managers representing the six departments who attend meetings to support, present, and answer questions. Members of the administration and citizens make presentations when there is a public hearing or a standing policy committee meeting. For meetings that are open to the public to attend, they can sit in the gallery. Citizens can also watch council and committee meetings online through the live stream. Media attend council and committee meetings and report to citizens. They have their own media booths above chamber. There are three banks of flags in Council Chamber. First, the Alberta, Canada, and City of Calgary's flags. The city's red and white flag with the letter C and a cowboy hat was chosen through a competition in 1984 in honor of the city's centennial. 10 flags representing the Canadian Armed Forces Groups, Calgary Police Service, and Calgary Fire Department. And 8 Indigenous flags representing Bearspaw First Nation, Blood Tribe or Kainai Nation, Chiniki First Nation, Piikani Nation, Siksika Nation, Soutina Nation, Wesley First Nation, and Métis Nation. Quiz time! Do you know where the Treaty 7 First Nations are located? The Blood Tribe or Kainai Nation is here, the Piikani Nation is here, the Siksika Nation is here, the Soutina Nation is here, and the Stoney Nakoda is here, and includes Bearspaw First Nation, Chiniki First Nation, and Wesley First Nation. The official City of Calgary crest was adopted in 1902 and includes our motto, Onward, and the dates of Calgary's incorporation as a town in 1884 and as a city in 1894. Her Majesty Queen Elizabeth II, Queen of Canada's portrait, is a reminder that we are a member of the British Commonwealth. The Olympic flag is to commemorate Calgary as the host city of the Olympic Winter Games. Quiz time! In what year did Calgary host the Olympic Winter Games? The answer is 1988. The City Hall School is where citizenship and municipal governance come alive. Students and teachers can visit for a week-long, custom-designed educational program. Moving up to the third floor, you can find the cashier's office, the Fair Entry Program and Services, and the Building Services Center. Floors 4 to 12 are where some of the city's administration work, including the City Manager's Office, Corporate Security, Human Resources, Finance, Community Planning, and Facility Management. The city is developing and improving inclusiveness through Indigenous awareness. On the 11th floor, the meeting rooms have all been given Indigenous names. Some of the names include Oki, a Blackfoot-friendly greeting, Donitara, a Sutina-friendly greeting, Donche, a Métis-friendly greeting, and Umboa Stitch, a Stony Nakota greeting, which translates to, "Hello, today is a good day and all is well." Historic City Hall was built between 1907 and 1911. It has been Calgary's seat of civic government for more than a century.
Quiz time! What type of material is Historic City Hall made out of? The answer is sandstone. The original sandstone came from the J. Lewis Quarry, where the community of Panorama Hills is now located in northwest Calgary. After the 1886 Great Fire destroyed 14 buildings in the city's core, a fireproof building material was required for all new buildings. Calgary became known across Canada as the Sandstone City.
Historic City Hall is the only surviving city hall from its time in Western Canada. The building recently underwent an extensive exterior rehabilitation and is intended to serve Calgary for another 100 years. The clock is the only remaining timepiece of its kind in Canada. Only 50 of this model were ever manufactured, and today fewer than 12 are operating worldwide. The clock and its 1,500-pound bell were installed in 1911 and designed to strike on the hour. When visiting Historic City Hall, you'll find the Office of the Mayor, the Grant McEwen Library, where the mayor meets with delegates and distinguished guests. Grant McEwen was the 28th mayor of Calgary from 1963 to 1965. And Calgary Power Reception Hall is a space for formal ceremonies and events hosted by the mayor and councillors. The 14 councillors and their staff have offices on the third floor and fourth floors. Moving to the administration building, on the first floor, you'll find the City of Calgary Archives. The archives were created in 1981 to safeguard and make available Calgary's municipal government records and city information. Historical records and information can be found relating to record created by the City of Calgary and City Council activities, parks, planning, property assessments, transportation, and Calgary events. Everyone is welcome to research the record held at the archives. The second floor of the administration building is where the Annie Gale Boardroom is located. Annie Gale was the first woman in Canada and possibly in the British Empire to be elected as an alderman from 1917 to 1923. Outside on the Municipal Plaza is a three-story tall monument called Walls of Memory, Lantern of Light. This memorial pays tribute to Calgary's police officers and firefighters who have lost their lives in the line of duty. On the opposite side of the plaza are tribute walls with statues of a Calgary police officer and a Calgary firefighter. Next to these tribute walls fly five flags. All flags are symbols of honor and pride. The main bank of flags from left to right include Canada, first in the position of honor, Alberta, Union Jack, Calgary, and Treaty 7. Quiz time! When there are only three flags, Canada, Alberta, and Calgary, do you know which order they should be displayed? The answer is Alberta, Canada, and Calgary, with Canada in the middle in the position of honor. You can learn more about flag protocols at calgary.ca/flags.
There is a courtesy flagpole where cultural and nonprofit organizations can apply to have their flag raised for one day per year.
Along the front of the municipal building fly the provincial flags in the order of when the province joined Confederation, starting with Ontario in 1867 and ending with Nunavut in 1999. Quiz time! When did Alberta join Confederation? The answer is September 1st, 1905, same date as Saskatchewan. The Lion is one of the four original lions that were once on the Center Street Bridge. It weighs 12,600 kilograms and was modeled after the bronze lions in London, England's Trafalgar Square. The Family of Horses is a bronze sculpture that signifies the bond, kinship, and strength among families. Across the street is Olympic Plaza. The plaza was built for the medal ceremonies for the Olympic Winter Games. It has the only refrigerated outdoor ice service in the city. It converts to a splash park in the summer and used for special events. Municipal government. There are three levels of government in Canada: Each level of government is responsible for different areas of society. The federal government, led by the elected prime minister, is responsible for areas such as Indigenous relations, immigration, and national defense. Each constituency in Canada is represented in the House of Commons by an elected member of parliament or MP. The provincial government, led by the elected premier, is responsible for areas such as energy, education, and the healthcare system. Each constituency in Alberta is represented in the Legislative Assembly of Alberta by an elected member of this Legislative Assembly, or MLA. The municipal government, led by the elected mayor, is responsible for local services such as transit, fire, police, parks, recreation, water, waste, and recycling, to name a few. The citizens of Calgary are represented in the City Council by an elected councillor for each ward. In Canada, the Governor General is the federal representative of the head of state of the Canadian monarch, the Queen or King. The Governor General is appointed by the monarch on the advice of the Prime Minister. In each province, there is a Lieutenant Governor who represents the monarch. The Lieutenant Governors are appointed by the Governor General on the advice of the Prime Minister. Quiz time! Do you know who the current Prime Minister of Canada, Premier of Alberta, and Mayor of Calgary are? Take a moment to think of who they are. The role of City Council is to govern the city and ensure it provides the services Calgarians need and want. City Council must respond to citizens' immediate concerns and opportunities. They have to anticipate and plan for long-term development and growth and provide direction to administration. City Council consists of the Mayor of Calgary, who represents the entire city, and 14 councillors, each representing one of the 14 wards. A municipal election happens in October every 4 years. To vote, you must be at least 18 years old, a Canadian citizen, and a resident of Calgary on election day. Quiz time! Do you know which ward you live in and who your city councillor is? Take a moment to find your ward on the ward boundaries map. Calgary's form of government is called a council policy committee system. There are 2 standing policy committees and 3 standing specialized committees. Councillors sit on these committees and are responsible for approving and recommending policies to City Council to vote on at an upcoming combined meeting of council. Citizens are encouraged to attend committee meetings and speak to the various issues. They are also invited to speak to land use issues and other topics at public hearing meetings. Boards, commissions, and committees advise council on many topics. There are approximately 90 boards, commissions, and committees. Each has a particular mandate, reporting regularly to City Council on their specific area of importance. Every summer, the city invites citizens to apply for vacant positions that are available. In 2015, City Council directed the Calgary Aboriginal Urban Affairs Committee to review the Truth and Reconciliation Commission summary report and determine which of the 94 calls to action are actionable by Calgary's municipal government. The report was published in 2016 and named the White Goose Flying Report. The report was named after Jack White Goose Flying, who, at this time, is the only known child who died at Calgary's only residential school. He was 17 years old. Quiz time! Do you know the name of the residential school in Calgary? The answer is St. Dunstan's Anglican Industrial School, located in Ogden, which was opened from 1896 to 1907. The Calgary Aboriginal Urban Affairs Committee recommends that the city implement 43 of the total 94 calls to action by the Truth and Reconciliation Commission. The bridge over the Bow River was opened in 1910 and was named after Sir Hector Louis Langevin, one of the fathers of the Canadian Confederation and known for his part in assimilating Indigenous students in the Indian residential school system in Canada. In the spirit of reconciliation, the City of Calgary renamed the bridge in 2017 to Reconciliation Bridge, a name that signifies building communities rather than dismantling them, and is a powerful symbol of mutual respect for the future. Also in 2017, the Treaty 7 flag was raised with the main bank of flags on the plaza as Call to Action Number 45, from the White Goose Flying Report.
In 2021, with the discovery of 215 unmarked and undocumented graves at a residential school in BC, a memorial of shoes and children's items was formed on the Municipal Plaza. At residential schools across Canada, it is estimated that there were more than 6,000 deaths. As of early 2022, 4,100 have been confirmed. The city is committed to calls to action number 79 to create a school site commemoration and number 82 to establish a permanent monument.
This memorial will help Calgarians to never forget that there were Indigenous peoples living here before newcomers arrived. The Municipal Government Act grants Council the power to pass bylaws. Bylaws are created as a way to address the issues and concerns of Calgarians. They are created to protect the environment, public health, public safety, or to maintain order throughout Calgary. A few well-known bylaws are community standards, parking, parks and pathways, public behavior, responsible pet ownership, smoking and vaping, and waste. To have a new bylaw created or an existing bylaw amended, start by talking to your city councilor. Quiz time! How can you get involved with municipal government? The answer is, there are lots of ways to get involved. If you see something good or bad, call 311. Talk to your counselor. Submit a comment or speak to council or a committee on a hot topic. Join the conversation and provide your input through Engage. Learn more by watching a council or committee meeting. Join a board, commission, or committee. Vote at the next municipal election. Run for mayor or councilor. Apply for a job with the City of Calgary. City services. The City of Calgary's administration is responsible for managing and delivering 61 services to make life better every day for Calgarians.
Led by the city manager, there are 7 departments that oversee all the services.
Planning and development services are responsible for imagining and planning a great city. Infrastructure services are responsible for designing and building a great city. Community services are responsible for connecting and protecting citizens and communities. Operational services are responsible for operating, maintaining, and delivering critical services that Calgarians rely on. Corporate planning and financial services are responsible for driving value and performance within the organization. People, innovation, and collaboration services are responsible for empowering and enabling employees.
The city manager's office is responsible for leading and inspiring the organization. And, of course, we have citizens and businesses at the center of all that we do.
Some of the programs and services that the City of Calgary is responsible for: transportation, which includes traffic and driving, road permits, construction projects, road maintenance, transportation planning, cycling, and Calgary Transit. Bylaws and public safety, which includes bylaws, public safety, Calgary Fire Department, Calgary Police Service, and land use bylaws.
Environment,
which includes recycling, composting, garbage, water services, environmental management, climate change, and Calgary's trees. Parks and recreation, which includes children and youth programs, parks, recreation, and arts and culture. Building, planning, and business, which includes business and the local economy. Animal services, which includes responsible pet ownership, lost cats and dogs, adoption, animal complaints and programs, and volunteering. Social programs and services, which includes affordable housing, youth programs, community services, and fair entry low income assistance, and taxes and property assessments. The city's award-winning 311 service provides citizens, business owners, and visitors with access to non-emergency city services. If you see that a streetlight is out or there is a pothole on your street, use the 311 app. Call 311 or visit calgary.ca/311 to submit a service request. 311 also accepts thank you messages for city employees who go above and beyond to make our city great. Symbols, history, and artifacts. Calgary's history goes back to 1876. Initially called Fort Brisbois, the name was changed by Colonel James McLeod to Fort Calgary in 1876 when the Northwest Mounted Police were brought into the area to catch whiskey smugglers. The fort has been established where the Bow and Elbow Rivers meet. This is where the Fort Calgary Interpretive Center sits today. Quiz time! Do you know when Calgary became a town and then a city? The answer is, Calgary became a town in 1884 with a population of 506. 10 years later, a city in 1894 with a population of 3,900. There are several symbols that represent the city of Calgary. You've already seen Calgary's official flag and the City of Calgary crest. Quiz time! Do you know that Calgary has its own song? Composed and written by Barry Bowman and Tom Loney, Neighbors of the World is the official song of Calgary. Calgary was presented with its own tartan in 2003. The tartan is an official and registered symbol of Calgary that any person can wear whenever and wherever they like. Calgary's floral emblem is most commonly known as the red pasque flower, which was officially adopted by City Council in 1991. The red pasque flower is a perennial that begins to bloom in early spring, typically around mid-April. Have you ever seen it? To commemorate the 100th anniversary of Calgary's incorporation, the mayoral chain of office was created in 1985 and presented to Mayor Ralph Klein. The chain is entirely hand-engraved on sterling silver and marks the wearer as the first citizen and a person of some importance. As you walk around the municipal complex, you will see a variety of artifacts, sculptures, and artwork that have been gifted or loaned to the City of Calgary. Highlights include the four pillars outside Council Chamber. On one pillar is a sculpture that honors Chief David Crowchild. He is the late chief of the Soutina Nation. Engraved in plaques at the base of the pillar are names of the recipients of a memorial award in honor of Chief Crowchild. The award is presented to individuals who demonstrate a commitment to Indigenous issues and promote understanding between Indigenous and non-Indigenous cultures. There are four teepees, all of them with their doors open because his doors were always open. Many of the items are based on actual items owned by Chief Crowchild, such as his beadwork and buckskin. On the other three prominent pillars, Indigenous artist Taytum created three pieces of artwork titled Past, Present, and Future, which represent the rich history of the land on which Calgary sits and how all people are working to understand the wrongs of the past and provide a way forward for the future. Official visitors to Calgary are given a handshake and a white hat when they arrive, known as the White Hat Ceremony. This official Olympic torch was presented to the City of Calgary to commemorate the Olympic Winter Games, held in Calgary in 1988. The Olympic torch relay began in St. John's, Newfoundland, and finished 88 days later as 12-year-old Calgary student Robin Perry lit the cauldron at McMahon Stadium. It is made with a tapered Canadian maple wood handle, styled after the base of the Calgary Tower. Pictograms of the 10 official Olympic winter sports are laser-incised into the maple. The bowl resembling the top of the Calgary Tower is made of recycled aluminum. The bronze boots are in honor of the hundreds of Calgarians who volunteered to help after the flood in 2013. Flood water filled all 7 levels of the City Hall parkade. 26 communities were evacuated and approximately 110,000 Calgarians were affected. This mural is a depiction of Calgary's namesake, the Bay of Calgary on the Isle of Mull, Scotland, and was painted in celebration of Calgary's centennial in 1984. The display cases below the painting are changed out every 6 months with different historical content from the city archives. Métis artist David Garneau was commissioned to create this series of sculptures of famous Albertans to commemorate Calgary's 100th birthday. These ceramic works represent 5 figures from Alberta's past. George Murdoch was a saddle maker by trade and became the first mayor of town of Calgary from 1884 to 1886. Patrick Burns was the first person to transport livestock on the Canadian Pacific Railway. He was a very successful rancher, one of the big four who founded the Calgary Stampede, and was appointed as an Alberta senator. Robert Bob Edwards was a publisher and editor of Calgary's Eye Opener newspaper. He was elected in 1921 to the Alberta legislature, but died in 1922. Samuel Livingston immigrated from Ireland. He was an explorer and one of the first farmers and ranchers in Calgary. He is considered Calgary's first citizen. Jerry Potts was Métis and respected by the Blackfoot as a hunter and warrior. As a guide, scout, and a skilled multilingual interpreter, he was invaluable to the Northwest Mounted Police, playing a key role in their mission to end the whiskey trade. Quiz time! What other names do you see when you drive around the city of Calgary with significant meaning? To name a few, Sarcee Trail is named for the Soutina people, who were also known as the Sarcee. Deerfoot Trail is named after Scabby Dried Meat, also known as Deerfoot. He was a prominent long-distance runner from Siksika Nation in the 1890s. Glenmore Trail is a Gaelic word for Big Valley, a name given to the area by explorer Sam Livingston. Memorial Drive is where the lost sons and daughters of our community are remembered, and the sacrifice that our citizens made for our freedom and security are honored. Called A Slice of Life in Calgary, 1985, this time capsule contains memorabilia, including material from the 1988 Olympic Winter Games. The capsule is scheduled to be opened in 2084. Quiz time! How old will you be in 2084 when the time capsule will be opened? What do you think is in it? What would you put in the time capsule today? The city of Calgary shares sister city status with six cities around the world. The exchange between each city and Calgary can be in areas such as culture, economy, and education. Calgary's sister cities are Quebec City, Quebec, Canada, Jaipur, India, Daqing, China, Nakopan, Mexico, Dajin, Korea, Phoenix, Arizona, USA. There are two ship models named after the city of Calgary. The larger of the two is the HMCS Calgary that has served in the Canadian Forces and Royal Canadian Navy since 1995. Calgary is the sixth vessel in her class and the second vessel to carry the designation HMCS Calgary. The ship's bell was also gifted to the city.
That concludes our virtual tour. My name is Taytum, and I want to thank you for joining me today.
If you want to learn more about the history of Calgary, visit the City Archives in the Administration Building or online at calgary.ca/archives. For an in-person tour of the Municipal Complex, go to calgary.ca/complextours for details. Have a great day!